Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Osteo Med. This is a series of videos on e-learning osteology. This particular topic is Norma Frontalis, Part 4. Here we cover the oral region. In the earlier discussions, previous videos, we have introduced the norma frontalis of the skull in three regions: frontal, naso-orbital, oral. This edition, this particular video, we will cover the oral region. This area basically consists of two bones, maxilla above and the mandible below. That means the area around the mouth region. In more detail, you can see the alveolar processes, that is the sockets for the teeth. The maxilla has the upper row of dentition. The mandible has the lower row of dentition. Now, a little in detail about the mandible. The two halves of the mandible are fused at the symphysis menti, that's a vertical ridge running from the alveolar ridge, alveolar sockets down to the lower border. But a little above the lower border, this ridge bifurcates into two called the mental tubercles, and there is a small pit in between the two. This whole area in and around the mental tubercles is called the mental protuberance. It's called the mental protuberance. You can see the same in surface view. Now, few additional features. A prominent mental foramen is seen on the body of the mandible, a little lateral to the symphysis menti. Once the body of the ramus we have identified, the next item to identify is the ramus, or nothing but a quadrilateral upper projection from the posterior part of the mandible. Now this ends in two processes, anterior coronoid and a posterior condylar process. In a strict norma frontalis, the coronoid is right in front of the condylar, therefore it is not very clearly seen. Hence, I have deliberately used a slightly angulated view, I would say an anterolateral view. Again, this slide is more for orientation, although it is strictly not norma frontalis. Here is a sagittal section of the head and neck region. You can see the hard palate and the cross section of the mandible. In between the two, you can see the orientation or the location of the tongue. Now, this is very important. The hard palate is mainly a maxillary contribution, and lower down is the mandible. To continue, you can see that's the tongue, and in front are the lips. Now, this is norma basalis. I have put this view deliberately because it brings a completion to the discussion. The maxilla forms the major contribution to the hard palate. There is a small contribution from the palatine bone, a little behind that. We will see it in a more detailed discussion later. This is a slide borrowed from the previous video. This is an MRI coronal section, head region. You can see the lower part, that is an oral region, clearly highlighted. That's the hard palate, the upper blinking arrow, and the lower one is the alveolar process with teeth. Please leave your feedback either on the blog available below the YouTube video, or you can write me at this email ID. This is a presentation from St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, India. Just like osteomed, that is osteology, we also have a histomed, VBS histomed, a series of 90 plus videos on the histology for healthcare students, medical, dental, physiotherapy and allied courses, of course nursing included. Thank you.